and telling him that I was done and I was ready to kill myself and I was ready to die and I was ready to, I mean, I was really laying it on thick. I mean, how he ever stuck by me is the biggest wow, right? What was I gonna say? When I was feeling those feelings, I kept thinking I just wanted his jealousy to be done. I wanted his corrections to be done. But no, all this perspective has taught me I want to stop feeling so affected by him. I want to stop feeling so deeply hurt when he's not approving of me. I want to stop feeling so deeply dependent on him in such a way that it makes me feel like living or dying. Do you know? I am so done with that. I'm so done with being so dependent on him to the point where I don't know where our marriage is going to go now. I mean, I want to stay together with him. But do you realize the last 12 years has been me asking him his opinion on everything, me making sure he's okay with everything? You know, I don't think he likes that all the time. I know he appreciates it once in a while, but what's it gonna look like when I don't need his approval for everything? When I don't need him to sign off on all the decisions I do or don't do? I need him to understand that I'm going to do this self-love thing where it's not going to have him included in my decision-making process. I'm going to keep the decision to stay married. At least that's the plan. I don't want to force this marriage to stay together if he doesn't want it to. If that's where it ends up, I guess that's where it ends up. That's the real sad part to think about, that if he can't allow me to do this self-love thing on my own without him, without needing all this approval from him, he may not want to stay with me if I end up not needing him anymore. He may decide that, so I have to recognize that. He may decide that he needs me to be dependent on him. He needs me to come to him for everything. He needs me to check in with him of all my decisions and all my thinking and all my. But I think he wants me. I'm pretty sure he wants me to feel confident. I'm pretty sure he wants me to feel good about myself. I'm pretty sure he wants me to stop feeling like crap. And that's what I was telling him last night. I said, those episodes where I'm on the floor and I've got the scissors to my skin and I'm just sobbing my eyes out blaming you, that can't happen anymore. Therefore, me coming to you for every little thing I'm thinking about, to seek your approval, that can't happen anymore either. That's the other side of this rainbow, if you want to call it that. That's the other side of this circle. You can't expect me to not have these episodes anymore, but still do this, still be dependent on him for every little thing, because the only reason why this was happening was because I was so dependent on him for everything. The only reason why I was so ready to die and being so suicidal in front of him was because I was seeking his love. I was seeking his approval. I was seeking him to stop being so angry with me. I was seeking him to fix me. I was wanting him to meet my emotional needs. And the only reason why I was wanting him to meet my emotional needs is because, hello, I'm depending on you to meet my emotional needs over here too. So these two extremes need to go away. I need to stop being so emotionally dependent on him for every little freaking thing. And he needs to let me. Otherwise, I'm gonna have these things over here. I'm going to keep having them. For example, 6:45 in the morning, he's snoring. I'm antsy. I got to get up. I got to talk to myself. I got to work this out. I got to get this on tape before I forget about it. I cannot go back to sleep. This is hot stuff. I've got to do this. But I'm not going to talk to myself in bed while he's sleeping. That's kind of rude, right? I really don't have another room in the house to talk to anybody in like this, right? I'm going to sneak out to my car and record this video. I'm not sneaking because I'm doing something wrong. I'm sneaking because I don't want to wake anybody up. I'm going to be respectful of their sleep. So, I quietly leave the room. I quietly leave the house. And I jump in the car after getting sprinkled with the sprinkler. And I talk to you. But for a moment there, I'm thinking, oh no, he's going to want to know what I'm doing. Oh no, he's going to think that he needs to be jealous. So I should probably just stay here. Crystal, wake up. You cannot keep doing that. You cannot keep allowing yourself or denying yourself self-love in the fear that it's not going to meet Jim's approval. Okay? I would have laid in bed denying myself this opportunity to talk to myself and get this on my video like I want. This is my version of self-love. I would have denied myself this self-love in fear of his rejection, in fear of his, you know, getting of disapproval. And you know what? I said, screw that. I don't need his approval for this, Crystal. I'm like, good, you don't need his approval. So as I'm leaving the door, I'm like, what happens if he says, and I'm like, just